Today's video is about dispelling the biggest myths about coffee. I personally love coffee and cannot imagine my mornings without a cup of this beverage, and furthermore, as a dietitian, I feel obliged to defend it because coffee has been falsely accused by negative PR, but the evidence tells a different story than commonly held views. Many people live with the belief that drinking coffee leads to a permanent increase in blood pressure that ultimately leads to hypertension. I believe this to be a very harmful myth, as the result of scientific studies indicates something entirely different. Additionally, coffee is one of the best research products in the world, particularly in terms of its impact on blood pressure and the occurrence of certain diseases. So what can we learn from the review of the latest scientific literature? Scientists from Mayo Clinic in Minnesota have shown that drinking coffee has no significant impact on either systolic or diastolic blood pressure. Other researchers have noticed that consuming up to 5 cups of coffee a day only causes a small, clinically insignificant increase in blood pressure, around 1 to 2 mm of mercury on average. I would also like to mention the most recent results of an analysis of multiple scientific studies published in 2018 in the respected Journal of Human Hypertension. The authors of this study considered 10 studies involving almost 250,000 people in total. What did they observe based on these studies? They unambiguously stated that drinking coffee protects us from developing hypertension. Although this protective effect is not particularly high, it strongly denies the false belief that drinking coffee causes this disease. Scientists noticed that the higher the portion of coffee, the lower the risk of developing hypertension. For example, drinking 2 cups of coffee a day reduced the risk of hypertension by 3%, 4 cups by 5%, 6 cups by 8%, and 8 cups by 10%. Of course, this doesn't mean that drinking a barrel of coffee will protect one from hypertension 100%. As with everything, moderation is key, as more does not necessarily mean healthier. Additionally, the latest research from 2021 showed that the protective effect does not apply to cigarette smokers. Therefore, if one smokes cigarettes, drinking coffee is likely to make no difference in protecting them from hypertension. One may wonder how it is possible that coffee does not cause hypertension when caffeine, which it contains, increases blood pressure. In addition to caffeine, coffee also contains substances with hypotensive effects, such as magnesium, potassium, niacin, and polyphenols. Moreover, researchers have shown that drinking coffee reduces the risk of insulin resistance and hyperinsulinemia. As we know, this can contribute to retention of salt and increased activity of the sympathetic nervous system, as well as to harmful proliferation of the smooth muscles of blood vessels. Interestingly, it is thought that people who regularly drink coffee develop some tolerance to the caffeine contained in it, and as a result, the consumption of coffee does not cause a noticeable increase in their blood pressure. At this point, I would like to add one more important issue that many people ponder. While coffee is good for healthy individuals, what about those who already suffer from high blood pressure? Can they drink coffee? Spanish scientists responded to this question. They carried out a review of scientific studies and noticed that the consumption of pure caffeine in the form of tablets by people with hypertension causes a significant and long-lasting increase in both systolic and diastolic blood pressure. However, such an effect was not observed in people who drank coffee. Moreover, drinking coffee by hypertensive patients does not increase the risk of cardiovascular diseases. Therefore, it can be said that drinking coffee, of course in moderate quantities, is safe for people with hypertension. To sum up all that I have said, firstly, drinking coffee can only lead to a short-term, transient increase in blood pressure that returns to normal levels within a short time. Secondly, drinking coffee mildly reduces the risk of hypertension and does not increase it. Lastly, people with hypertension do not have to give up coffee completely. I believe 1 or 2 cups a day should be safe. There is another myth related to the first one, which claims that consuming coffee allegedly increases the risk of cardiovascular diseases. I don't want to delve into this aspect too much. I will only cite the results of a comprehensive scientific study, which directly showed that drinking coffee has a protective effect on the cardiovascular system. The researchers unequivocally confirmed that drinking 3 to 4 cups of coffee per day reduces the risk of developing cardiovascular diseases by 15%. Drinking one cup of coffee a day also has a protective effect, although the efficacy is lower. It is also worth noting that coffee also reduces mortality from cardiovascular causes by 19%. Repeating that coffee is dangerous to the heart does not correspond to hard scientific evidence. I suspect that there is not a single person who drinks coffee on a regular basis who hasn't been accused of the notion that coffee depletes calcium and magnesium. But where this assumption that drinking coffee makes us deprived of these valuable nutrients come from? Well, coffee has a mild diuretic effect, and this is probably why people think that by drinking coffee we might lose calcium and magnesium. If you think that coffee is an enemy of calcium and magnesium, then you should see the result of research in this area. The results of the research show that by consuming 400 mg of caffeine, which is approximately 4 cups of brewed coffee or 4 shots of espresso, we lose only 4 mg of magnesium from our body. This is less than the amount of magnesium which coffee provides by itself. I will not even start discussing the fact that this 4 mg is a drop in the ocean, as we consume about 300 mg of magnesium on a daily basis. And what about calcium? Scientists discovered that drinking one cup of brewed coffee might lead to a loss of around 4 mg of calcium. This is significantly small, since we consume approximately 500 to 1000 mg of calcium on a daily basis. If, however, you would like to make up for this trace loss, although there is no need for it, you just have to add 1 teaspoon of milk to your coffee. Therefore, pointing fingers at coffee as the source of calcium and magnesium deficiency is pure misunderstanding. One of the biggest myths about coffee is the claim that it dehydrates. Similarly to the case of magnesium and calcium loss, the diuretic effects of caffeine are behind the supposed dehydrating action. However, I would emphatically say that coffee can be comfortably included in one's daily water balance. Let's quickly go back to the diuretic effects of caffeine. For caffeine to act diuretically, it has to be consumed in amount of about 400 to 500 mg, which is the equivalent of about 5 cups of brewed coffee. Now let's move to coffee itself. In 2014, a study was published in which scientists were trying to determine if coffee actually dehydrates. For that, the volunteers of the experiment were split into 2 groups. The first one was given 800 milliliters of coffee and the second one 800 milliliters of water. In order to assess the impact of coffee on dehydration, the researchers analyzed several important parameters related to hydration. Researchers looked into certain parameters including total water content in the body, daily urine volume, urine and serum osmolarity, creatinine concentration in urine and blood, and hematocrit. After completing the test, they noticed that there were no significant differences between the participants who drank coffee and those who drank only water. This clearly indicated that coffee does not dehydrate. Moreover, in 2015, one of the most renowned magazines in the world, the American Journal of Clinical Nutrition, published a study that compared the effects of various drinks on the body's hydration status. For some, the results of the research were quite surprising. It revealed that coffee has a hydrating effect, although it is slightly weaker than that of water. In another study, scientists showed that even if the caffeine intake of 300 mg, which is equivalent to about 3 cups of brewed coffee, acts diuretically, the amount of urine released is still lower than the amount of fluid ingested. Therefore, the water balance remains in the positive. Some people believe that coffee can cause cancer and increase the risk of developing cancer. These suspicions likely stem from the presence of acrylamide in coffee. Acrylamide is a component that forms during the thermal processing of food products. In the case of coffee, it is formed during the roasting of the beans. In 1994, the International Agency for Research on Cancer classified acrylamide as a probable carcinogen for humans. Since then, scientists have conducted numerous studies, most of which have shown that acrylamide is not the cause of cancer development. It is also worth noting that acrylamide is present in French fries, roasted almonds, crackers, potato chips, peanut butter, and breakfast cereals. Let me leave acrylamide aside and look at what scientific research says about coffee directly. After conducting my own research, I concluded that coffee is probably one of the most studied products in terms of its impact on cancer development. Research has shown that regular coffee drinking can reduce the risk of various types of cancer. Specifically, it is associated with a 5% reduction in risk of breast cancer, a 15 to 54% reduction in risk of liver cancer, a 31% reduction in risk of oral cancer, a 13% reduction in risk of colorectal cancer, an 11% reduction in risk of prostate cancer, a 27% reduction in risk of cervical cancer, and 11% reduction in risk of melanoma. Researchers have actually shown that drinking coffee can only increase the risk of lung cancer. Additionally, the International Agency for Research on Cancer has mentioned that it has classified coffee into group 3, which are substances impossible to classify as carcinogenic to humans. Hence, I believe that coffee is not carcinogenic, and drinking it might even protect us from many types of cancer. I hope that with today's video I was able to dispel some misconceptions about the health aspects of coffee. Unfortunately, these myths become the truth for many people the more often they are thoughtlessly repeated. In my opinion, coffee is one of the healthiest drinks, and if you consume it on a daily basis, it can be beneficial for you. It has so many beneficial properties that I will soon make a separate video about it. Meanwhile, I encourage you to watch another video about coffee on my channel. More specifically, what to combine coffee with to get an even greater health effect. To watch the video, just click on the thumbnail that just appeared on the screen. That is all from me for today. Thank you for your attention, and I will see you next time.